We're going to talk about a couple limiting cases when we're dealing with this equation over here that relates our change in circulation with respect to time to gradients in density as well as pressure. And we're going to talk about two limiting cases, the case of a barotropic fluid, which we're going to talk about now, and eventually next, baroclinic fluid. So we're going to talk about our barotropic fluid first. For a barotropic fluid, what we mean over here when we're talking about a barotropic fluid is one where our lines of constant density or our contours of constant density are parallel to our contours of constant pressure. And so what that means in this particular case is that going up in the atmosphere over here, if we have relatively higher pressure near the ground, decreasing pressure with height above ground, all of our lines of constant density will be parallel to our lines of constant pressure like this. So here's rho 3, rho 2, rho 1, where closest to the ground, we have gravity pulling all the air molecules down. So our lines of constant density are parallel to our contours of constant density are parallel to our contours of constant pressure over here. Remember, where we're lower in the atmosphere, gravity is pulling all the air molecules down. They're all bunched together, much higher density than higher in the atmosphere over here. So if we plot our del rho, it's going to be pointed down, perpendicular to our contours of constant density. And then towards higher values of density, so del rho. And del p is also going to be pointed down as well, just like this, perpendicular to our contours of constant pressure, pointed towards higher values of pressure. So in this case, when we're dealing with del rho cross del p, remember, the magnitude of this, the magnitude is going to be related to, again, our magnitude of del rho times magnitude of del p. The important part is the sign of the angle between del rho and del p, which in this case, for our barotropic fluid, is zero. And sine of zero is going to be going to zero over here. And so for our barotropic fluid, d gamma dt is zero, and we don't have any generation of circulation or loss of circulation. D gamma dt is zero for barotropic fluid, no gain or loss in our circulation. And we can also see that mathematically over here. If we remember our term for barotropic, for our term for the d gamma dt over here. All right, so we established that for a barotropic fluid, this integrand over here goes to zero. Let's just see going backwards from a step and using Stokes theorem that this term over here, remember, can be expressed as minus closed path integral of dp over here over rho, or write that as minus closed path integral of 1 over rho times dp. We can write that as minus closed path integral of 1 over rho dp d rho times d rho. And we can do that. We're just taking over here dp over d rho times d rho. These effectively cancel out over here, or divide out, rather. And so remember, for a barotropic fluid, we can say that density is only a function of pressure. So that would mean that this whole term over here, dp over rho, over here, density is only a function of pressure. Dealing with density over here. So we can express this over here as minus closed path integral of d of some function over here, d rho over d rho times d rho, just like this, where this is could be some function over here. And then we can express this as minus closed path integral, d rho's cancel out of d of some function over here. And now we have the closed path integral of d of some function over here, which means that this can go to zero, since we talked about closed path integral of a perfect differential here going to zero. And so indeed, this equality holds true where we took the sine of the angle between del rho and del p, which is zero, giving us zero. Well, we found that even going back from Stokes' theorem, the same holds true over here, which is good since we're dealing with inequality here. And d gamma dt is indeed zero for the case of the barotropic fluid. Now we're going to contrast this next with baroclinic fluid, where density is a function of both pressure and temperature. And we get horizontal gradients in temperature that drive circulations, which we're going to talk about next.